Welcome to CACE International. I'm Fakisha Kumbo. We're on location tonight at Sigma Studio in the heart of Manhattan with the dynamic group Full Force and young songbird and Patti LaBelle protege, DESIREE COLEMAN. But first, Jimmy Cliff, Jamaican-born international reggae star and movie actor, who is probably best known for his star roles in the cult movie The Harder They Come, and co-star role along with Robin Williams in the hit movie Club Paradise, has a new album and video release called Hanging Fire on Columbia Records, and it is hot. Produced by Callis Bayan, who is Ronald Bell of Kool & the Gang, and Jimmy, the material is divided between tracks recorded with two of Africa's newest bands, and the songs done with his band, Oneness, at the Tuff Gong Studios in Kingston, Jamaica. He recorded Love Me, Love Me, the album's first single, with the Grand Zyco Band of Zaire, Africa, a group as comfortable with the pulsating rhythms of Africa as they are with the synthesized sound of the 80s. Let's enjoy a bit of this entertaining video with the Hanging Fire album. Baby Jerry, Taurus, who likes girls to play with his teddy bear. His motto is, never say never. Paul Anthony, Virgo, who enjoys bodybuilding and says, enjoy life because it is very short. Bow-legged Lou, lead and background vocals. Cancer, he spends time looking for bow-legged women. He says, always believe in yourself, and may all the positive and optimistic things in life be yours. Be fine, Cancer, loves the Porsche 911. He says, go for yours, because 100 years from now, it won't matter. So always try to get yours. Kurt T.T., Gemini Taurus, enjoys driving sports cars and hunting for girls. He says, always go for the women with the big, shapely legs. Shy Shy, Virgo, who likes eating salads and ice cream sundaes. His personal motto, go for it. Desiree Coleman, a young lady with a 5-octave range. For 3 years, rather 3.5 years, she played the lead role of Doris Winter in the original Mama, I Wanna Sing cast, a long-running off-Broadway play. Desiree astounded all of us with that magnificent vocal range. In 1986, she played Phoebe in Bob Fosse's musical Big Deal on Broadway. At 16, she won the Miss Teenage Universe contest. She's appeared in Elle and Interview magazines. Her 1988 album release on MCA will probably be called Desiree Coleman. Welcome, Desiree, to CACE International. I'm glad you could take the time in your busy schedule to come by the studio tonight. So we're on location. I understand that Armstead Edwards, Patti LaBelle's husband, is your manager.
Yes, he is. He's been managing me now for 3 years.
What does the future look like? What's the horizon for your career?
Well, hopefully to be very successful and to just not only perform, but to give a message while performing.
What kind of message?
Well, right now I'm singing secular music, but I hope to sing inspirational music, gospel music, and just music to reach different people, to give different messages to not only young people, but adults as well.
Well, I can certainly see that's one of your ambitions. Do you have others?
Yeah.
Tell me what they are.
To further my acting career, I did a few things, very small things. I believe the biggest thing that I did on television was Go Tell It on the Mountain with Olivia Cole and so many people, great people, and that was a real great experience for me. Mm-hmm. And I think one ambition would be to further my acting career. Mm-hmm. I really would like to do that.
What is it like being associated with the fabulous, the fantastic, but yet the for real Patti LaBelle?
I think you just said it. It's for real.
Yeah.
And she's like a second mother to me. I think I can go to her and express myself like I would express myself to my mom. She's just great, her husband's great, her son's great, everybody's great to me. Mm-hmm. And I appreciate them.
So what does your acting career look like for you now?
Well, I've gone on several auditions, got several callbacks, didn't get a movie. But one's coming.
Sure.
When the part's right, when I feel that it's something that I want to do, I really want to do, and that I'm right for at the same time, then it'll come.
When did you first start singing?
When I was 6 years old.
And how did that happen, was it?
Well, my mom used to sing. She was an entertainer, and she'd have a band at the house, and I'd watch her. And as I said before, I started singing in church, and besides that, I would sing into a hairbrush. And at 6 years old, I remember singing Aretha Franklin's Call Me. And I sang that song every day, and when my mom would have company over, she'd say, come in here and sing Call Me. And that's how I basically got started.
Oh, that's really great.
Thank you.
And I'm real proud of you, because you've really done well in the time that you've been out on the scene. Suppose you are a young girl in America who sees Desiree Coleman on television and say, oh, I want to be just like her. What kind of advice would you give that person?
I would tell her to just keep striving for her goals, and for he and she to keep striving and never give up. If you fall, just pick yourself up again and say, I can do it, never say I can't. And even if it's not one thing that you're good in, you're always good in something else because God has given us all a gift. And I would just say, keep striving for that gift, and sooner or later, you'll get yours.
Oh, listen, I want to really thank you. I know you're in a hurry, and you have to run. And I want to thank you for taking the time out to come over and be with CACE International.
Pleasure.
Thank you.
Thank you.
DESIREE COLEMAN, songbird, protege of the great Patti LaBelle. Welcome to CACE International, Full Force.
How you doing?
All right. Thank you so much for inviting us into your job, you know, your studio. First of all, let's introduce each of you.
Okay, my name is Kurt. I play lead guitar.
I'm Baby Jerry. I play keyboards.
I'm Bowlegged Lou, co-lead singer.
I'm Paul Anthony, one of the lead singers.
And I'm B5.
And you dropped your bracelet.
You dropped everything.
Come on, baby. Get it together.
Let's go.
Your success with the Lisa and the Cult Jam has been phenomenal. What does it mean for the career of Full Force?
Kurt? Bowlegs?
No, well, it means a great deal for us because as much as we're artists, we're also producers and writers and arrangers and co-managers, because we also co-manage Lisa and all of our acts. And it means a great deal, you know. That's why we're looked upon and really respected in the industry, you know, very versatile.
It means more money, too.
P5, he's something else.
Your new album, Guess Who's Coming to the Crib? Mm-hmm. You say it's aimed straight for the children. What is the involvement of the children in that album?
B5?
The involvement of the children in that album is part of me. Go ahead.
Well, we aim it to the kids because we make music for kids. Kids meaning your 14-year-old adult to your 38-year-old toddler, okay? That's what we call the kids. But there's certain references such as 3 o'clock, school's out, that we make sure it's for the kids, and you better take care of homework. It's a well-rounded album and has something for everybody because we're just everyday people, so everybody can get into it, but we gear towards the kids.
Recently, Full Force produced James Brown's album, I'm Real, mm-hmm. for CBS and Scotty Brothers.
Right.
And it's fierce and it's funky. Tell us about that experience.
That was an experience. We wrote and produced the whole album.
Good God, hit me!
We won't give you the whole album.
Hit me!
They approached us with that project. And we've lived in James Brown for years, like most of us, like mostly everybody in the industry. And it was an experience. We're in awe of no one we produce or meet, but James Brown was, that was it, because we've dreamt on doing him. And first thing we said to him was, Mr. Brown, we love you, okay? That's where we are, we love you. You helped raise us, and we live on you. Everyone from Mick Jagger to Run DMC has taken from you, and all we ask is for your love and respect, and we're going to put you where you belong, on top.
After that, it was kind of smooth.
Yeah.
You know, I noticed...
Easy sell.
Yeah. I noticed on your album, Guess Who's Coming to the Crib, some sounds in that sound just like James. somebody says, hit me, and I don't know if it's James or if it's full force. I mean, it sounds just like him.
Well, no, it's James Brown.
That is him, yeah.
But see, we're very close, so at least we have permission,
right?
Unlike other people that sample James's work has no permission, but we do.